For this assignment, you'll need the Robot Lab, so download it using the link on this page if you haven't already. A Unity classic, this is the first thing you should try out in scripting, the classic spinning cube. A very simple thing to achieve, but an important first thing to try. Whilst you don't need the Robot Lab for this, you can use an ordinary primitive cube. It's worth downloading the package for use with other assignments. For this assignment, open up the empty scene in the Scenes folder in the Project panel. Then go to File, Save Scene As to back it up. We'll save this as Spinning Cube and save it into the Scenes folder. Because we've done Save As, we're now inside that scene. Go to the Models folder and grab the prop_power cube and drag it into the scene. Using the Translate tool, drag it up in the Y-axis and then press F on the keyboard with your cursor over the scene view in order to focus on that object. We'll quickly set up the lighting for this. Make sure that this object is on the Dynamic Objects layer. And then in the Mesh Renderer for the object, check Use Light Probes. Now let's make our script. Click the Add Component button at the bottom of the inspector, go to New Script, and call your new script Spin, and click Create and Add. Once it's added, double-click the icon for the script to launch it for editing. In order to make our cube spin, we'll need to modify its transform every frame, so we'll make use of the update function. Delete the start function and the comments that are in the script. We want to be able to control the speed of this using the inspector, so we'll make a public variable that we can adjust there. Start by adding a public float variable, a decimal place number, called speed. Then, as stated, we'll affect the transform of the object. So to begin, we'll start by saying transform.rotate. And into the brackets we'll specify a rotation. We're going to use vector3.up, which is a shortcut to world space up direction. The vector3 0, 1, 0. And then we'll use our speed variable and multiply this by time.deltaTime in order to smooth it out. If you're not familiar with deltaTime, check out the lesson on this link below. We'll also give our speed variable a default value. When we're done, we'll save our script and return to Unity. Now all we need to do is press play, and we have a spinning cube. And because the speed variable is a public variable, we can adjust it whilst the game is playing. One other thing you may wish to do to finish this scene off is to select your camera, so underneath Cameras, choose Camera 01, and with your scene view showing exactly what you'd like to see in the game, select the camera and go to Game Object, Align with View. That will move the camera to the view that you have set up in the scene view. Now you can just press play again and watch the results of your work.